Hello students, today we are going to start a new topic called speed, distance and time. So here we will first see this concept, then two system we will see CGS system and MKS system and SI system in fact. Then we will go to the sums. So see here, I was staying in Asansol, now I am in Kolkata. So distance between these two, there are two lines children, one chord line and one main line. Okay, that I'll tell you later what is the difference. One is shorter and one is little longer. So generally train takes, so this is called distance. Distance is 200 kilometer. Let's take time, it take 4 hours to travel 200 kilometer. There are train like Rajdhani which takes 2 hours 10 minutes, Jan Shatabdi and Purva and all, they take 2.5 hours. So generally when it comes via mail line, it takes 4 hours. Anyway, just for the sake of simplicity, I take this as 200 and this is as 4 hours. So there are two things we see. Distance between two places means what is the length between two towns. Okay, so we take in kilometer. Second is the time taken. So speed, if you see children, the concept comes, speed is distance by time. Okay, means what we do here, 200 kilometer by 4 hours, we write the unit also. So speed is 50 kilometer per hour, means the train on an average, see any train, any bus cannot go at a constant velocity. Like buses, you have bumper, you have traffic jam, you have turning, so there we have to slow down. Similarly trains, okay, there are station where they stop, so they have to slow down and stop. Some places signal is not always green. So this is called average speed basically. More we will see later on. Okay, what is average speed? Is total distance by total time. So better we call it average speed. Actually speed over here means average speed children, because at any moment, it's called physics, you will see instantaneous speed. Instantaneous speed means at that particular instance. So every moment if you see, when you are going by a car or a bike, you can see the speedometer, and one shows the length, I think it's called odometer, how far you go, distance. Okay, so there are two things if you see. One shows the speed of your vehicle where you have an arrow like thing, pointer like thing, and down you have one display which gives you the distance travel. I think it's called odometer, ODO. You just check that. Okay, so we know the distance, we know the speed. So what speed is shown by the speedometer of your vehicle is what we call instantaneous speed at that moment. Anyway, let's come back to average speed. So speed means average speed over here children. So 50 kilometer I go in 1 hour. So let us divide this into 4 parts. So in 1 hour I cross 50 kilometer, another hour 50 kilometer, I can write 1 hour, 1 hour, okay, another hour I travel 50 kilometer, and the last one I travel 50 kilometer. So basically if you see, if you define speed, speed is the distance traveled per unit time in 1 hour. Speed is distance traveled, that is 50 kilometer in 1 hour. So 4 hour, just the opposite children. Speed is distance by time. Distance, if this goes up, I have taught you that in my simple equation video, is speed into time. Means if I go with the speed of 50 kilometer per hour and I travel 4 hour, hour will also cancel. You have to take care of the unit. More later on you will see in physics also. So we travel 50 kilometer. One table I'll give you children, which will make your understanding of the unit more clear. So very soon I'll make a table. So once more, speed is the distance traveled per unit time. So there are two units children, kilometer per hour, and another I'll show you meter per second, SI unit. Okay, kilometer per hour and meter per second. And if you go to CGS, CGS may be centimeter per second, so we don't use CGS. SI unit is meter per second I'll talk, and this is kilometer
per hour. So 50 kilometer per hour is my speed, means every unit time, either 1 second or 1 hour, I travel. In this situation, 1 hour, 50 kilometer. So once more, speed is distance traveled per unit time. Means in 1 hour, I travel 50 kilometers. So 4 hour, I'm showing you, we travel your 200 kilometer. Okay, not 50 kilometer, 200 kilometer. So two basic concept I gave you: speed is distance traveled per unit time, distance is speed into time, children. And last but not the least, if you bring time here, time is distance by speed. Speed comes here, the interchange, and time goes up. So one simple, one more short example, in the SI unit, meter per second. What we have another unit, children, if you see, if I travel, one example, 30 meter, suppose, in time, this is distance, children, D, time I travel in 5 seconds. So my speed is distance travel. When you divide distance by time, we get distance travel per unit time, means per second I travel 6 seconds. Second 6, so 6 5s are 30. So once more, I'm teaching you in another unit, I travel 30 meter in 5 seconds. So when you divide distance by time, we get distance traveled in unit time. So this will be every second I travel 6 meter, 6 meter, 6 meter in another second. So like that, I travel in 5 seconds, 6 meter, 6 meter, and finally, just I am elaborating it, okay, 6 meter. So every second I travel, this is what is the concept of speed, distance traveled per unit time, and the time here is second and distance is in meter. So in the next part, after I rub this, I'll give you one table about the unit of speed, distance, and time. So here I travel in 5 seconds, if you see, at the speed of 6 meter per second, I travel 30, 6 5s are 30. So once more, concept of speed is distance travel. When you divide by time, per unit time, means in 1 second, how much I travel, in 1 hour, how much I travel. So our mother formula is speed is distance by time, or distance, in the other way if you see, is speed into time, 4 hour you multiply, and time. So this is my first formula, second formula, and third formula. So together we call it formulae. Speed is distance by time, distance is speed into time, time is distance by speed. So with two example, I'll give one table in the next part, and we will do few question. And one very important thing I'll tell you, how to convert from meter, kilometer per hour, to meter per second, and meter per second to kilometer per hour. That conversion, that will help you in class 7 physics. We have one chapter, then all the higher classes you have this concept, so it will help you there. It will help you in physics up to at least class 11 and 12. So kindly pause the video and copy, and we come back to see the units. So children, we move on to next part. This is very important. You can see my one video I made for class 7 physics, numerical, very first chapter. Some children, they said, sir, there are two type of question there about density, which is mass by volume. Very similar, children. Okay, mass is in kg, volume is in meter cube. So density is very similar concept, mass by volume. See, maths and physics are twin brothers or sisters, you can say, and they go together. Okay, and generally that's why you'll see maths teacher is physics teacher and physics teacher is maths teacher in many school. Okay, so very good combination, and they enrich each other. So distance, so this two numerical I remember. So some of my children last year told, so for numerical, especially that part, okay, I made one video, you can see that, class 7. Okay, so distance, we have two ways, kilometer per hour. Generally now hour we write by h only, and second, if the distance is in meter, time is in second or s. So speed is distance by time. I have given you example, children. So speed will be kilometer per hour. Okay, HR or H. So when distance is in kilometer, time is in hour, speed is kilometer per hour. If suppose these two things are given, if speed is given, time is given, if they are in this unit, distance will be in kilometer. If distance is in kilometer, time is in, speed is in kilometer per hour, time will be in hour. Same thing, meter, this is SI unit, of this distance is meter, time is second, so this is meter per second. Okay, so if the speed is given and time is given, if this is the unit meter per second and this is second, distance will be in meter. So another thing you please copy, there are a lot of things I'll teach you to note. Number one is 1000 meter is 1 kilometer. Okay, second thing you see, 1 hour is 60 minutes and each minute is 60 seconds. So 1 hour, children, is 3600 seconds. Once more, 1000 meter is 1 kilometer. These are the basic tools. And one very important thing I'll do before I take the sums is how we convert from these two units. So maybe my first video I'll stop after giving you concept, then in my second video I'll try to do the sum. So this video I think is basically about the basic concept of speed, distance and time, which I have already given you. Here I am talking about units, okay, which are the two main units, and one or two important conversion, and finally the most important conversion, where we learn how we convert kilometer per hour to meter per second and meter per second to kilometer per hour. I told you this will be useful to you not only in maths at this stage, in physics and maths, up to any level you go, this basic concept remains same. So kindly pause the video and copy. Then in the last part of the video, I'll teach you conversion. So in the last part of the video, children, we are moving to conversion from kilometer per hour to meter per second. See nicely, something very important I'm going to tell you. So if you see kilometer, just I told previous discussion, 1 kilometer is 1000 meter and 1 hour is 60 into 60 second. See how one thing leads to another thing. 1 hour, 1 kilometer is 1000 meter and 1 hour is 60 into 60. Let us cancel, children. So we get, if you see, 5 by 18 meter per second. Very important, children. 1 kilometer per hour is 5 by 18 meter per second. One example and one table I'll give you, which is very important. Let us see if you have, okay, multiple of 18. Suppose I take example and one table I'll give you. 18 kilometer per hour. Suppose if you have. How we will convert? See here. We multiply by 5 by 18. 18 into 5 by 18 meter per second. As soon as you multiply, children, kilometer per hour changes to meter per second. As soon as you multiply. So it's 5 meter per second. Okay. Same thing, children, if you do 13, you follow table of 18, follow table of 5 here. So 36 kilometer per hour, okay, here we'll get 36 into 5 by 18 is 10 meter per second. So one table I'll give you in short, children. 18 kilometer per hour is 5, okay, so this conversion, you see, kilometer per hour to meter per second. So if you see, if this is 18, this is 5, this is 36, this is 10, this is 54, this is 15, this is 90. 18 fives are, follow table of 18, 5 fives are 25 meter per second. So this is in kilometer per hour and this is in meter per second. Already I have written the unit over here. So remember this. So if it is 9 children, this will be 2.5. So remember, very easy thing I taught you, from kilometer to meter per second. 18 gives you 5. See here the value 18 kilometer per hour. It's 5 meter per second. So remember, kilometer is big, 18 kilometer per hour and meter. Actually the basic logic is this, how we convert. So kilometer is big and meter is small. Actually it's hour and second also. So 18 becomes 5. So in meter per second, the value is less. Okay, and just the reverse we will see in the last part of this video, where we convert meter per second into kilometer per hour. 5 by 18 will become 18 by 5. So kindly pause the video and copy, and this table you remember, it's very important. If you multiply by 10, 180 kilometer per hour will be 50 meter per second. Here you follow table of 5, here you follow table of 8. 360 kilometer per hour, the speed of the aeroplane, we have multiplied by 20. So multiply 25s are 100 meter per second. Okay, so it's very important and very interesting. So kindly pause the video and we move on to the last part of this concept. So the last thing in this part one of the video, we are going to see how to convert meter per second to kilometer per hour. So this is my part one, and in part two of my video I'll try to do a few questions from exercise 9. Okay, now meter per second. So kilometer per hour, if you remember children, we converted by 5 by 18 meter per second. So here just the opposite, this 18 comes here. See how you will remember, kilometer per hour is 5 meter per second. Okay, 18 comes. So this is, I have shown you, 5 meter per second is 18 kilometer per hour, and this is, if you take out 5 here, 1 meter per second is 18 by 5 kilometer per hour. So 1 meter per second is 18 by 5. So just remember one side relationship which I have derived on this side on the beginning of the previous part. Now, so if I have 5 meter per second children, so it will be 18 by 5. As soon as you multiply with 18 by 5, meter per second will become kilometer per hour. Remember in the previous video I said, as soon as you multiply by 5 by 18, so kilometer per hour becomes meter per second, and here meter per second becomes kilometer per hour. So 5 meter per second is 18 kilometer per hour. Same way, if you take 10 meter per second children, if you multiply 18 by 5 into 10, it will become 36 kilometer per hour. So we can make a very similar table. So you can copy this also. So very similar table we can make, where if we have meter per second and we convert it to kilometer per hour. Okay, so first 5 meter per second is 18 kilometer per hour. So here table of 5 will go, and here table of your 18 will go. 5 5s are 25, 18 5s are 90. So if you have 50 meter per second, so here 10s are, it will be 180 kilometer per hour. Okay, similarly if you take aeroplane, generally goes with the speed, any passenger aircraft, 100 meter per second. See 100 meter race, we see Olympic and all, the world record is around 9.8 second. They travel 100 meter, but here if you see aeroplane moves 100 meter in 1 second, so which in kilometer per hour is 20 times, so this will be 360 kilometer per hour. So if your speed is 360 kilometer per hour, then you travel 100 meter. If you have seen school race and all, junior school you have 50 meter race, senior school you have 100 meter race. So this last part children is very important for physics and maths both. Okay, I told you they go together, they enrich each other. So kindly pause my video and copy everything, and in the part two of my video I'll do some basic question where I'll highlight all this concept. So thank you children for watching this video lesson.